Imagine if their dream was, I wish I could just stand over there. I mean, like, sit over there. Yeah. Or I wish I could just move a little bit, move my toe. But their dream was, I wish I could walk.
Yeah.
That's what dreaming big is. What's up, guys? Welcome to the third episode of In the Fire. I'm your host. This is my co-host.
What's up, people?
Guys, I'm super excited for this episode. Thank you guys for tuning in. Whether you're listening on Spotify, iTunes, or watching us on YouTube, we appreciate you guys. We love you guys. Hope your week is going amazing.
Mm-hmm.
Like I said, this week, this episode, I'm super excited for.
Yeah, it's something big on your mind. Big things.
Just like the title, dream big, stop dreaming small. Dreaming small is setting us back.
Yes, sir.
I love it. I love it because I've always been an advocate of dreaming bigger. So. Yeah.
Definitely. So I think before anything, I think a good start to this is understanding, you know, what's the issue with dreaming small.
Okay.
So that's what I want to ask you, Danny. You know, what are the dangers of just dreaming small?
Wow. There's a lot of dangers. When you dream small, you're limiting yourself.
Mm.
You're kind of like enclosing yourself in a cage. Because when you dream small, you're saying that's... In your mind, what you're telling it is that's the max that I can go, right? So if I say, you know, I'm going to get to this certain point, that's as far as you're going to get because that's what you set your mind to.
Mm.
So when you dream big, even if you fail, you beat that smaller thinking.
Mm. It's like basically you're increasing the capacity that you think you can do. And that all goes with like how you think, right?
Yeah.
If you think that you can only do a little bit, you can only do that much.
Yep.
So it's like for you, you're saying it's like we're increasing the capacity that we can actually do something in our mind, like saying we can do more in our mind, and then that becomes like our reality.
Yeah.
Yeah. And like, yeah.
I know it's funny because when you said that, it reminded me when I go to the gym, right? Mm. Yeah, I go to the gym, guys.
We don't see it. I'm just kidding.
Nah, but okay, so when I go to the gym and I've trained like a friend or two friends, I've trained two friends now.
Mm-hmm.
But when I go to train one of them, I remember telling him like, make sure you aim for higher numbers, right? So we'll do a set, we'll do like a rep, right? And I always, our goal is to hit 12 reps.
Mm.
And I've realized this through my experience in working out. When I tell myself, okay, this set, I'm going to hit 8 reps. Once I hit 8, that's when, like, I'll be knocking them out. I'm going crazy. I hit the 8 reps. As soon as I hit 8, my body shuts down and it's like, oh, I can't do anymore. And then I stop at 8. What happens when I say, nah, I'm going to hit 12. I don't actually hit 12, but I tell my mind that I'm going to hit 12 and I get to 10, maybe even 11 because I dreamed bigger, right?
Yeah.
I said, I can hit 12. And in my mind, I told myself I could hit 12.
Wow.
I didn't actually hit 12, but I hit higher than the 8 that when I was dreaming smaller.
Wow. So it's like, it's very restrictive.
Yeah.
Right? Because when you tell yourself, I'm going to hit 12 reps, you're again, like you're increasing that capacity or you're actually giving yourself the chance.
Yeah.
Like if you always tell yourself, I'm going to do 8 reps every single set, like you're not telling your body, maybe you can do more.
No, and like you just said, you don't give yourself the chance.
Yeah.
You're, like I said, you're limiting yourself. So when you don't give yourself the chance, there's no way you're going to hit that bigger thing because, and you'll never know if you could hit that because you never tried.
Yeah. And dreaming big is like the spark to that, right?
Yeah.
Because if you're always thinking like, I'm going to hit 8 reps or I'm just going to do this and not actually have the big dreams for it.
Right.
Like you're not giving yourself the chance. You're not giving yourself the opportunity to actually achieve more than you can.
Yeah.
And with that working out analogy.
Yeah. Another factor that goes into it is actually believing it.
Hmm.
You can't just tell yourself, I'm going to do it and I want to get there, but you actually have to believe because if you don't actually believe halfway, you're not going to actually do it.
Wow.
I remember, and the same thing, let's keep going with the working out analogy. I told my mind in the beginning, I'm going to hit 12. There was one where when I got to 6, I thought in my head, wow, this is so heavy. I can't do this.
Yeah.
The second I thought that, boom, drop the weights, hit 8. So you have to actually believe you can get to that number. Mm. You can get to that area that you want to be in your life. Because if you're dreaming small, you're limiting yourself.
Yeah, and also with that thing where you said, you know, it's so heavy. Like, a really important part, which I know I can speak about a lot, it's like your mind with it. Like, how you tell yourself things, you know, like with that, like, I can't do it, it's too heavy. Well, yeah, now you're going to feel like it's going to make the way out easier.
Yeah.
Like what you said, like, oh, dang, this is mad heavy. Yeah. I'm going to drop the weight because it's mad heavy. Or you can say, this is mad light. I'm not going to drop the weight because it's mad light. Like, it's what you say to yourself and also what you say out loud.
Yeah.
Like, if you're saying, like what you said, if you're saying to yourself, this is really heavy, though, your wanting to drop it increases because you keep on saying what's heavy instead of saying what you can do.
Exactly.
So it's like you're building up the foundation of, oh, this is harder, instead of building up your confidence foundation. You're saying, this is harder, instead of saying, I can do this.
Yeah, and that's what I wanted to say was, a lot of times, the reason we dream small is our low self-esteem.
Mm.
Our lack of confidence in ourselves, that's why we dream small. Because you don't see yourself achieving those bigger things, so you're always aiming for smaller.
Wow.
I know somebody that is stuck at this one job.
Mm-hmm.
And every year or so, they'll say I'm praying for a raise. I'm praying for like a $1 raise. And I looked at him. I said, stop. And she's like, what's that? What happened? I'd be like, you need to dream bigger. Mm-hmm. You're at a job you don't like and you're praying for a dollar raise. You should be praying for a dream job where you're making so much more money.
Wow. Yeah.
And you know, yeah. She's like, oh, but this is not allowing me. Okay. I never said that you'll get to that point. Mm-hmm. I mean, you could if you kept going and you strive for it. You're not going to get to that point right away.
Mm-hmm.
But the idea is, instead of you staying at this one job, hoping for that dollar raise, now what you're doing, you're going on websites. You're emailing people because you want to find a new job. You're actually trying to find a better job in advance.
Yeah.
But when you're sitting at the same thing and you're just dreaming small, like, oh, I hope I get a dollar raise. Okay, now you got the dollar raise. Now what?
Wow. Another year?
Another year. A
whole year.
And the dollar raise, for some people it might be like a lot, but at the end of the day, you're just going to keep wanting more.
Mm, yeah. And so it's like when you dream big, I remember I heard this, you have to see it before you see it.
Yeah.
Like right now in that situation, you know, it's like all she sees is just like the work and the dollar bill. But like you have to, like vision, like you have to have a vision for it, right? Like or just you have to dream big about it, right? When you dream, you have your eyes closed.
Yes.
So it's like you have vision with your eyes closed. Like when you have your eyes open, all you do is you're just seeing.
Yeah.
But when you have your eyes closed, that's when you're dreaming.
Exactly.
So you can't really you can't dictate your dreams with your situation. Right. You have to be able to see, okay, I want to do this. I want this to happen even though I don't see it right now. So my dream isn't like, even though my dream isn't the same as what I'm seeing. Again, it says in the Bible, we walk by faith, not by sight.
Right.
We might not see it, but we have to, you know, have it in our mind where we want to go and having our vision and our dreaming big for sure.
And going off of what we just talked about like the confidence and seeing, you know, that vision, right? The reason people are stuck in this little thinking, in this dreaming small, is because when you don't see results, your confidence gets hurt.
Yeah.
Right? So let's say this person that I said about the job, right? Let's say she actually tries to go for a bigger job.
Mm-hmm.
Fails, doesn't get it. Confidence is beat up. She's going to go back to her small thinking. You see, like, it didn't work. I'm going to go back to trying to strive for that dollar raise. So that's why people get stuck in this mentality, because since they don't see results, their confidence and their ego is getting beat up even more. Mm. And now she doesn't want the dollar raise. Now she wants 50 cents raise.
Oh my gosh.
Because of that ego and that confidence that was beat up.
So but how can we overcome that? Like, how can we not let ourselves get into that like beat up mindset?
I think it's the acknowledgement that we will fail. You will fail.
Hmm. Yeah.
But out of the 10 tries that you tried, you got one.
Yeah.
Out of the 100 that you tried, you got one.
Hmm.
But if you tried 9 instead of 10, what if that 10th was the one and you didn't try because you're confident? And wow. I know, like, so when I was starting the podcast, right, when I was setting everything up, people, like, close to me were coming up to me and saying, like, are you ready for the podcast to do nothing? And I was like, what do you mean do nothing?
Yeah.
Like, are you ready to have 10, 20 viewers, a few views a week? Like, are you ready for that? And I was like, yeah. Because, and I've given you this analogy when we talk about it, right? It's that miner that's mining, right? He's mining, and he gets tired right before he gets to that gem. Mm-hmm. And I told him, I was like, absolutely. I don't care how long this takes. I don't care if it takes a year, 2 years, however long it takes. But I will reach a higher view count. I will reach that point that I want to reach in because I'm confident in that point. And I see it. I see the, what was the one that you said? I see the sea. I what?
What, the vision?
When you have to see what?
You have to see it before you see it.
You have to see it before you see it. Exactly. So I saw it before. I saw the vision, mm-hmm. right? And I'm determined to get there.
That's awesome.
So it's like the acknowledgement to overcome that, you need to acknowledge that you will fail. That's one. Nobody, I mean, you could succeed on the first try, but what are the odds of that, right? Mm-hmm. So we have to always keep pushing no matter what and chasing our dreams, because if we just give up after that, not going to work. Not going to get there.
And I think a cool correlation I want to set is like dreaming big, but also like having faith too, right? Like throughout the whole gospel, it's like Jesus, like he's always talking about faith. He's always like, if you have faith, like the verse I like to recite a lot is if you have the faith the size of a mustard seed, you can move mountains, right?
Ooh.
So like, you know, he's calling us into this lifestyle of faith. Like, dude, if you only had a little bit, like a mustard seed is so little.
Yeah.
And he's like, if you have a little bit of faith, you can move a mountain. And a mountain, like we hear that and we're like, dude, no way.
Yeah.
Nobody can move a mountain, right? But like he says that because we have to like acknowledge, you know, what are our dreams, right? A dream somebody could have could be, oh, I want to have my whole family to be saved, right? I want to have all my friends to help me, to have real friendships. I want to have a God-fearing relationship with another, like with the opposite sex. I want to have a husband or wife that loves God, right? Yeah. And like sometimes our situations, like they can look so bad. And so we're saying, that's impossible.
Yep.
That mountain's too heavy.
Yeah.
You can't move it. And same thing with this. You can't do that. It's not going to happen.
Right.
So he compared, like, it's like a contrast, like a comparison between moving a mountain, which is like what seemed impossible. I mean, it's still impossible, but with our society now, it's like we see these dreams we have.
Right.
And we say it's impossible. It's too heavy.
Yeah. I guess the faith goes along with the low self-esteem, mm-hmm. right? When you think lowly of yourself, that's just little faith. You have little faith.
Yeah.
Right. With the podcast, like I said, I have faith that we will get there. And since I have that faith, I believe that that mountain will get moved, right? And it does feel like a mountain because, you know, YouTube's a big, big platform. And I always think about it. Sometimes I say, I'm like, wow, like, how am I going to stand out over anybody else and get people to listen to us? But I have that faith that we will get there. So,
yeah,
you know, that little mustard seed faith that you're talking about, that's exactly what you need.
Definitely. That's and exactly what you need. You think about all the encounters that Jesus had with all the people, right? That got healed. Like, you have to think, they had that dream, right? You got to think the people that had leprosy or just were disabled, that couldn't walk. And their dream was, one day I want to walk. One day I want to walk. And everybody's like, you can't, dude. You're disabled. You can't do it. You can't walk. And, like, they had that dream.
Imagine if their dream was, I wish I could just stand over there. I mean, like, sit over there. Yeah. Or I wish I could just move a little bit, move my toe. But their dream was, I wish I could walk.
Yeah.
That's what dreaming big is.
Mm-hmm. And like you, all those people, they had the faith, I'm going to get healed. Like the woman that had internal bleeding, like for what it said, it said in the Bible that she had it for a very long time. And then like she said in her head, if I can only touch his clothing, then I can be healed.
Yeah.
Right. And then it's crazy because she did it. She went through the crowds and she touched it. And as soon as he touched Jesus' robe, Jesus was like, who touched me? Right, because he acknowledged that faith she had.
Who was that?
Yeah, like, I imagine she had faith. Like that's what you said. Oh, I'm gonna have faith that I can be over there so I can get money like better or something.
Yeah.
Or like, oh, I have faith that he can maybe heal my big toe. Like no, dude, they had faith that they can be completely healed,
fully healed.
And always Jesus said, because of your faith, you have been healed. So it's like, how much faith do we have in those dreams?
Right.
Like our faith always matters, and that's a main point. Jesus always wants to. Because it says in the Bible that without faith you cannot please God. Like you need to believe.
Yeah.
You need to believe that He is the God of like He's El Shaddai. He's a God He's a provider.
Yeah.
He is Lord. Like He can help you. He can make your dreams come true.
Right.
And He'll give you dreams too.
Yeah.
And but with that, like, you know, maybe the person that had leprosy, right? They had a dream. They want to get healed. Maybe they did. Maybe what if like they never had that dream? You know, like what's like, what's the danger of just not having a dream at all?
Ooh. That's even more dangerous of dreaming small. To me, that sounds like you've lost your spark. To me, that sounds like you're in a place where you're not even dreaming small anymore. You're kind of just there. And I've talked about this in the other podcast, in the other episodes where I said, like, you don't feel that spark and you're kind of just living day by day. Mm-hmm. You're not really dreaming. You're not, like, pushing yourself for greatness.
But why is that so common?
Ooh, why is that? That's a deep question. Yeah. There's a lot of things that can go into that factor.
It's like we're all kind of, like, content with being adequate or, like, just being eh.
Yeah.
Or just being almost enough. Like, we're content with just being, we're just doing what, like, is expected of us.
Yeah.
Not doing what we can actually achieve. That's even greater. Like, God is the God of, like, firsts.
Yeah.
Like, when Joshua, like, in the Bible, Joshua said, "Sun, stop." Right? And the sun stopped for, like, 2 days. And the sun didn't move. But he was the first to do that because of his faith.
Yeah.
Right? So imagine, like, in your life, you could tell, like, the sun and moon stop moving.
Imagine. Right? That'd be cool.
But, like, do we have that faith?
No, definitely not. Are we working? No, definitely not.
Exactly, because we're content with just being okay. We're content with just...
You know, I find that question really interesting because a lot of people ask, like, how come we don't see the miracles that we see in the Bible? Like, why don't we see those kind of miracles, like, today?
Wow.
I at a life group, I had a friend, and while we were all praying and asking, like, what's your prayer request for the week, right? People were saying, you know, my family, this, I have a big test. And one kid raised his hand, he said, "I want to pray for miracles."
Wow.
And I kind of, like, in my head at first, I was like, come on, bro, like, we live in the 21st century. Like, God, like, there's not going to be no miracles.
Yeah.
And that's the little faith that I have.
Wow.
Why don't we see miracles? Probably because we don't have that faith.
Yeah, definitely. It's like, it's a different society now, you know?
Yeah, definitely.
And, like, we don't really see resurrections.
Yeah, yeah.
Or, like, people, their leg being healed. We hear about it, like, you know, at our church and stuff, and it's awesome. But it's never, like, proclaimed. It's never like, yo, we healed somebody. Like, you know, it's not prevalent, which sucks.
Yeah.
Like, we lost our faith, basically.
Yeah. If you've lost that spark, I recommend you guys watch the second episode of our podcast. Yeah, it's really good. It's really motivating.
Yeah,
but definitely, you need to search for that ignition again.
Mm-hmm.
Something to light that fire inside you again. Because once you get that fire lit up, then you're going to start moving. Because you don't want to be sitting. You don't want to be sitting around and have that spark not be there. Because that's the worst feeling ever. I've been in that situation. It's not fun at all.
Yeah.
And I encourage you guys, try to look for that spark.
Mm-hmm.
Try to look for that spark. And the place that I found that spark, and a lot of people have found that spark, is obviously God.
Yeah.
So
he gives us purpose.
Yeah.
For sure.
And a lot of times I have people that, like, they look for that spark everywhere they could and they don't find it.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're there, I suggest, you know, you seek God. You'll definitely find that spark there.
Yeah. But, and, like, a verse I want to share about it, it's the verse here that says, "Where there is no prophetic vision, the people cast off restraint. But blessed is he who keeps the law," right? Another version of that says, where is it? It says, "When you have no vision, the people run wild." And, like, it's saying, like, if you have no vision, if you have no sense of where you want to be, you guys run wild. Or another version says, like,
That sounds like our society, like, as a whole. Like, that sounds like absolutely everybody. Yeah.
They're just running wild.
And they're just running wild. Yeah.
And it's crazy. It's like, it says that if you have no vision, no dreams, You're going to go wherever. You're going to go left, right, up, down.
Yeah.
But what's your goal?
Mm.
That's why it says people, like, it's also another version I was saying, like, the people perish when they have no vision. Like, you're just living. You're not actually living, right? Because there's this, like, God, Jesus always says, "I'm the life. Like, I've come to give abundant life."
Right.
Like, we're just living, but are we really, like, alive?
Right.
And so if we have that vision, then we can start, like, we're not going to perish. We're not going to run wild. We're going to run the race. We're going to run the goal we're going to. And sometimes people might not even have that goal, and that's where God comes in, right? In Jeremiah 29:11, it says, "I have plans for you to prosper, not to harm you. Plans to give you a hope and a future."
Right.
So it's like he comes and gives us that purpose and that vision when we don't even have it.
It's funny because when you mentioned the race thing, I felt that so much. Like I said, I felt the no spark thing. And I remember at the life group again, you guys talked about how we're all in a race and we all want to win. We all want to get to that finish line, that goal, right? And I remember thinking to myself, I want to get prayer for motivation to actually run the race.
Because
I felt like I was running and it kind of felt like I sat down. I'm like, I can't get there. I'm tired. I don't want to get there. So I prayed for that motivation and I got that ignition that I needed, that fire thrown inside me. And while everybody else was jogging, I was behind because I sat down for a while, but I feel like I'm sprinting. Feel like I'm sprinting. And it's because I started dreaming big again and I started, like, seeing this purpose for me. that I started striving for. And I remember when you said, back to the podcast thing, when you said, like, I think it's crazy that God told me do the podcast. I dropped everything I was doing, spent all the money I need to do, and I started the podcast. Because it's like, I see it, and if it's God's vision, what better vision could you have?
Literally, like, who can be against
it? Yeah, if he's the one dreaming big for me, like, dude,
if
like,
he's the one that gives the dream, exactly. It's sick. And, like, we have real examples on Earth. We have, what, like, Steve Jobs and people, like, I forgot the other guy who made, like, the gas engine or the engine. Like, dude, I heard that, like, one of his quotes was, like, you guys see it now, but I saw it before.
Ooh.
And I was like, dude, that's so sick.
Yes, yes.
It's like, dog, like, Steve Jobs made the iPhone, right? But, like, you got to think about it. He had the vision for it.
Yeah.
Before he was like, this is the iPhone. Yeah. He had it in his head. He was like, I'm going to make this phone. It's going to be touchscreen. It's going to have all this stuff.
Ooh, imagine.
But, like, you know what I mean? Like, it's like he took
and people thought that was not possible at that time. Yeah.
And he did it.
Yeah.
And, like, that's what I'm going to say. It's not even... Like, it's just you see it. You see it now. Like, people that don't even, like, know God, they're still, like, they have the dream.
Right.
They know what it means to dream big.
There's, you know, I feel like every episode I have a pet peeve, and this is one of them, is when people say, oh, come on, be realistic. Mm-hmm. Oh, come on, be realistic. In some occasions, that is valid for me.
Yeah.
Some case, like, people say, like, I'm going to win the lottery and I'm going to get rich. Like, I'd be like, okay.
All right.
Like,
yeah, no,
come on. Come on. But then when it comes to actually dreaming big, like, okay, I'm going to be the richest company in the world. I'm going to have like 20 churches around the world. Like, that's awesome.
That is awesome.
There's absolutely nothing wrong with dreaming that big.
Yeah.
Because to be honest, it's not that big.
No, it's not. Like, yeah.
For, like, the accomplishments that the people that you just named have gotten to, imagine what you can do. Sick. And that's the thing. That's why people dream small, because they don't actually believe they can get there.
Exactly.
Like, oh, I wish I was Elon Musk earning trillions of dollars a year. Like, you're not gonna get there if you're sitting around thinking you can't do it.
He wasn't, like, born in, like, oh, money. Oh
yeah, no, yeah, you know, Tesla went bankrupt for a little bit, and now look at them.
Yeah, and you gotta understand,
he didn't give up on his dreams.
Exactly, and that's like that's literally what Jesus said. Like, all things are possible to him who believes. So it's like,
geez, man.
If you believe something, you know, you're gonna go for that.
Absolutely.
And you're gonna get that because you believe hard enough. And if you're striving for that hard enough. Exactly. So it's like, we need to, like, we see it, Steve Jobs, we see that. Like, how much more can, like, we do with a God behind us?
Yeah.
A God that, like, has been through it all. He's like, whatever. I can do more than that.
Yeah.
You know, like, he has such big dreams for us, and we're, like, limiting him.
Exactly.
Like with that faith, it's like we have God behind us, right? It's like a big muscular dude. Like, imagine God, he's so built, right?
Yeah.
And he's, like, lifting, like, 5 pounds.
Right? Yeah, yeah.
But if we're only dreaming small, he's only gonna lift those 5 pounds when he can do way more. So it's like, when we have those big dreams, it's like, now he's starting to lift heavyweight because he can do that. Right.
That's when,
like,
you see more progress.
Exactly. It's like you're putting your weight on God, right? Your faith is grown when you put weight on it. You have faith that when you sit on a chair, the chair's gonna, like, keep you up.
Yeah.
So you have to put weight on God. Right. And when you put weight on him, you're going to see him, like, work in your life.
Right.
But you have to put that weight on first. You have to have that faith first.
Yeah. I wanted to share Jeremiah 29:11. I love this verse. For I know the plans I have for you. This is a famous one. A lot of people know this one. For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you, plans and not to harm you, plans to give you hope in a future. Mm. If he's saying he's going to give you hope in a future, what are you worried about?
Yeah.
Why are you asking for that dollar raise when you could be asking for so much more?
Yeah.
Right.
And a lot of times we want to choose what we want instead of what, like, the Lord wants. Right. And a lot of times, like, it's because what we desire, we're led by our desires.
Yeah.
And so, like, we don't want to let God guide us because he usually guides us in a place where we don't want to be at because it's uncomfortable.
Yeah.
But it's where we get to see more blessings.
Mm-hmm.
But again,
growth.
We have to, like, be obedient to that.
Yeah.
Like, if God wants us to go left, but we want to go right.
Mm.
We know that if we obey him, it's going to be blessings.
Yeah.
But it's way easier to go right because we want to do that.
Right.
And it's easier to do that.
Right.
But, like, when we're obedient to that, that's when we can see the true blessings.
Yeah.
And see the big dreams come, like, happening. Yeah. And, like, yeah, what you said too. He knows the plans, right? He knows us better than we know ourselves.
Yeah.
So if we allow him to work, allow him to do what he has to do in our lives, then we can walk in faith.
Yeah.
We can walk in purpose and walk in what we're made to be.
Right.
Which is, like, the purpose of life, dude.
Yeah, man.
It's to walk in purpose all day. And that God knows that, we can put faith in him.
Right. All right, so to wrap this up, this is how you got to improve on your thinking. You need to get up and you need to start dreaming big. Not dream small. You need to start dreaming big. Not that $1 raise, but that new job, right?
Yeah.
That's how you'll see growth, because if you're thinking too small, you're limiting God.
Definitely. It's like letting God giving you a vision, then speaking faith upon it,
yeah,
and then serving that vision.
Awesome. Awesome, man. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. This was episode 3 of In the Fire. We love you guys. Thank you guys for listening on Spotify, iTunes, or watching us on YouTube. We love you guys. We'll see you guys next week or next episode. Peace out.
Peace.